Hey guys, how's it going? So this video is all about PC gamers who are interested in building or upgrading their rig. So we will take a look at some of the best budget gaming CPUs money can buy today in 2020. So I will also review compatible motherboards, and at the end of this video, I will give you my recommendation on the best CPU plus motherboard combo for budget gamers in 2020. Note that links to everything that I will talk about in this video, including the CPU, the motherboard, RAM, and you know anything else that we discuss in this video, I will put everything below in the video description. So you can check out these links and you can get more details and up-to-date market price. So if you are on a tight budget but still want to build a kick-ass gaming rig, then AMD Ryzen 5 2600, which sells for about $120, that is the CPU of choice. So this is a 6-core 12-thread CPU, and it has a max boost frequency of 3.9 GHz. So this processor, it delivers not only competitive frame rates, you know, in gaming, but this is also an excellent CPU for productivity tasks, and it gives very good performance. So this CPU, it has a TDP of only 65 watts, and this makes Ryzen 5 2600 an attractive choice for anyone building a PC in a compact case. Ryzen 5 2500, this CPU comes with AMD Wraith Stealth Cooler, which should be good enough for most folks. I really appreciate the fact that AMD has included a good quality heatsink and cooler with the box. So this definitely saves precious dollars. You know, we are all on tight budget, and you can save some money by not buying the cooler, and you can invest that money somewhere else in your gaming rig. So Ryzen 5 2600, it is an unlocked CPU, and it can be overclocked using any inexpensive B450 motherboard. So the included heatsink and the cooler that comes with the CPU, it can handle moderate overclocking. However, if you plan to overclock this CPU above, say, 4 GHz, then it's going to struggle to maintain a healthy temperature. So, you know, if you upgrade from the stock cooler to something like a closed loop liquid cooler, for example, then you can overclock this CPU to up to 4.2 GHz. Now, if you are not interested, if you don't intend to mess around with overclocking, you know, not everybody wants to overclock. In that case, you know, you may want to try out Ryzen 5 2600X. So 2600X, it costs about $20 extra, and it bumps the base clock frequency from 3.4 to 3.6 GHz, and the max boost clock is increased from 3.9 to 4.2 GHz. So in Passmark CPU benchmark, 2600X is about 7% faster in single thread performance, and it's about 6.3% faster in the multi-thread performance over the Ryzen 5 2600. So note that 2600X, this CPU, it's also unlocked, which means you can also overclock this CPU and you can get even faster performance. Okay, so the next CPU we will talk about, this is the Intel CPU. So the closest Intel rival is the Core i5-9400F, and this CPU sells for $150. So this is also a 6-core CPU, but since Intel disables hyper-threading, you only get 6 threads instead of 12. So even though Core i5-9400F, it has a lower base frequency, it's only clocked at 2.9 GHz, it still manages to deliver a kick-ass single-thread performance. So in Passmark CPU single-thread rating, Core i5-9400F, it is 19.4% faster than Ryzen 5 2600, so that's really impressive. But since the Intel Core i5, it has only half the number of threads compared to Ryzen 5 2600, it falls behind in the multi-threaded benchmark, but not by much. It's about 3.8% slower than AMD. But here is the thing. Most of the games, at least as of now, most of the popular titles, they are not optimized for 12 threads. So that means Core i5-9400F, it is delivering a superior gaming experience even though it has less threads. And this is because it has a superior single thread performance. So here's the bottom line. You will get better gaming performance with Intel Core i5-9400F than Ryzen 5 2600, but it will cost you an extra $30. Now, if you have some more wiggle room in your budget, then look no further than Ryzen 5 3600. So this is currently selling for about $175, and Ryzen 5 3600, this packs quite a punch in a small 65 watt thermal envelope. So this CPU is also 6-core 12 thread just like Ryzen 2600, but this is a newer generation CPU, and it comes with a 7 nanometer compute die, and this compute die is paired with a 12 nanometer IO die. So the base clock speed of 3600 CPU, it's 3.6 GHz, and the turbo speed can go all the way up to 4.2 GHz. So compared to Ryzen 5 2600, this CPU is almost 40% faster in single thread workloads, and it's about 47% faster in the multi-threaded workload. Ryzen 5 3600 supports something called PBO. This is for automatic overclocking. And if you're not familiar with PBO, PBO actually stands for Precision Boost Overdrive. And this is an opportunistic automated overclocking mechanism that pushes the system power budget beyond its rated specification. And so this actually gives you higher performance. So this is a simple setting, you go and enable it, and your Ryzen 5 3600, it will overclock. So when overclocked, it offers same performance as the Ryzen 5 3600X CPU, which is $50 more expensive. So Ryzen 5 3600, it easily beats Intel Core i5 9400F in both the single and the multi-threaded benchmark. It clearly gives the best bang for your bucks in this price segment. So when it comes to productivity applications, Ryzen 5 3600, it offers far more value than Intel's competing chip. And this is because Ryzen has 12 threads, double that of Core i5. I mean, Intel has disabled hyperthreading, so that sucks. And the lack of hyperthreading on Intel CPU, you know, that makes this a no contest, and AMD wins hands down. Okay, now let's talk about compatible motherboards. So regardless of, you know, whether you pick Ryzen 5 2600 or 3600 CPU, the motherboards that I'm going to recommend here, they will work with both these CPUs without any issue. So if you are on a tight budget, then ASRock B40M Pro 4, this is an excellent motherboard, and it sells for only $75. So this motherboard, it supports overclocking both Ryzen 5 2600 and 3600 to 4.2 GHz. It also supports water cooling, making it a fantastic choice for overclockers. I like the fact that this motherboard comes with 4 DIMM slots and supports DDR4 3200 MHz RAM, which is, you know, the overclocked mode. So it supports a total of 64 gig RAM, which is more than enough for most folks. So this motherboard, it supports up to 3 external monitors. You can connect them all at the same time, and this will give you a kick-ass, you know, gaming experience. I also appreciate the fact that the dual M.2 slots support both SATA 3 and NVMe SSDs. So these are fast SSDs, and your Windows is going to boot very quickly. Now, if you have little more wiggle room in your budget, then I highly encourage going with MSI B450 Tomahawk motherboard, which sells for about $110. So the Tomahawk is a budget gaming themed motherboard, but comes with many features which are found on more expensive models. So it supports overclocking both Ryzen 5 2600 and 3600 to their max capacity, in addition to overclocking memory up to DDR4 3466 MHz. So the total memory capacity supported by this motherboard is also 64 gig, and you get 4 DIMM slots, so that's fantastic. This motherboard has great disk storage support. You get 6 SATA ports capable of supporting RAID 0, RAID 1, and the RAID 1 plus 0 array. It comes with a single PCIe 3.0 and SATA compatible M.2 slot for faster SSD drives. So again, you know, this is what I recommend. Go with an NVMe SSD drive, at least for the partition where you have Windows installed, and that will give you fantastic, you know, overall Windows experience. Now let's talk about the audio chipsets, because this is also very important for gaming. So the B450 motherboard, it uses high quality audio capacitors, which are all physically isolated from the rest of the motherboard circuitry. This leads to awesome audio quality during gaming and also, you know, during media playback. So I have linked both these motherboards along with the CPUs in the video description below. I have also added links to Corsair Vengeance LPX memory stick, which works best with both these motherboards. By the way, if you guys are interested in budget GPUs which you want to pair with this build, then check out my other video where I spoke about all the budget GPUs that are available, you know, as of now in 2020. And that video I've also linked in the video description below. Okay, so what do you guys think? Would you go with AMD Ryzen or the Intel CPU for your gaming rig? So please let me know in the comment section below. I hope you guys found this video useful. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below, and I will try to help you guys. Please like this video and subscribe to TechnoPanda for more videos like this. Also check out technopandareviews.com for more reviews focusing on laptops, gaming PCs, monitors, and, you know, other similar gadgets. Again guys, thanks for watching my video, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.